In this indoor PCB, the customer mentioned two problems. The first issue is that this diode here has burned out, and due to this, the PCB isn't turning on at all. Additionally, the customer mentioned that when they try to turn on the display with the remote, it only turns on with great difficulty, meaning the remote is not working properly. Now, we'll check what the cause of this is, but before that, we'll try to repair this PCB and see if it can be fixed or not. Here, there's an IC, which is a switching IC, and underneath this switching IC, someone has already soldered the base. So we can easily remove this IC, and I've successfully taken it out. You can see that this IC has burned from this spot, and one of its legs has burned, which caused this issue. Now let's check its number to identify it. It's a TNY276PN. We'll clean this area a bit. Now what's worth noting here is that when we physically inspect this capacitor, it's severely bloated. You can see that the cap has bulged upwards. Usually, when a capacitor reaches this state, it indicates that it's faulty internally. Due to its repeated failure, the IC might have also blown, so it's very important to replace this capacitor. The second thing we need to test here is the bridge rectifier. If this bridge rectifier is short-circuited, the problem will reoccur. So we'll test it using the diode mode and check if it's working correctly or faulty. You can place the positive and negative probes anywhere. It won't matter. There should be no reading or zero point displayed here. Now, we'll reverse the polarity and place the positive on the positive and the negative on the negative. Still, we're not getting any reading. Voltage drop is showing up on this point. So let's check the other points in the same way. This bridge rectifier is showing as completely okay, and no problems are visible here. Now, regarding this PCB, the customer complained that it short-circuited for the second time. So let's check why this is happening. First, we'll desolder it from here. We'll add a bit of fresh solder because the old one has become quite hard. Now we'll remove it from here, and similarly, we'll desolder the other side as well and take it out. It's now removed. We're going to install a new IC, but I'll tell you which one we'll use and what the difference will be. So here's the old IC that has burned out, but I will replace it with a TNY278PN. Now what's the difference between the old and the new IC? If we check the datasheet, we'll see that both belong to the same family and perform the same function. However, TNY276PN is rated 10 watts, while TNY278PN is rated 16 watts, meaning the current bearing capacity of the new IC is higher. Sometimes, if a smaller IC is installed and the PCB has a higher capacity, the IC keeps burning out repeatedly, and it becomes difficult to understand why. That's why I'll install a higher rated IC this time. Now, we'll place this new IC onto the PCB, and it's seated properly. Similarly, we'll remove the old capacitor because it also needs to be replaced. The new capacitor is almost the same, rated at 33 microfarads, 400 volts. We'll now install it, making sure to carefully observe the polarity, as the negative and positive sides are very important. If placed incorrectly, it will explode again. Now, looking at this diode, it seems to be okay, but it's essential to check it with a multimeter to confirm whether it gives us the correct value. The voltage drop for D2 is perfectly fine, showing 0.471. Now we'll reverse the polarity and check for any leakage or other issues. It's absolutely fine. Similarly, let's check D4. After testing, it's also perfectly fine, and after switching the polarity and checking again, the voltage drop is okay too. At the moment, there doesn't seem to be any issue, so what we'll do now is apply power to the PCB and check if the display turns on. I'll now turn on the power, and the display is turned on. Now, let's check the remote, because the customer complained that the remote wasn't working properly. I turned it on and tested it from a distance, and I don't see any fault. It's working perfectly fine. Sometimes, if the remote hasn't had its batteries changed for a long time, it may not work from a distance due to weak batteries. If the PCB had a fault, it would either work or not work at all. There are only two possibilities. At the moment, it seems fine to me. However, if the customer still complains, we will check it again. But for now, we have repaired the PCB successfully. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.